All that are visiting for the first time, you're in the Grand Old Church of God in Christ, where we believe in hand clapping, foot stomping, tongue talking. This is the Church of God in Christ. And the saints have come together tonight to give God a more excellent praise. And we're so glad about it. I want this Elder James Walker to come tonight with the inspirational message. Following Elder James Walker, amen, we're going to be led in the ministry of giving by Superintendent Robert Vini. God bless you. Amen. Let's say amen for Elder Walker. Amen. As he come and lead us at this time.
Amen. Let's say praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Protocol already being established and continued. Amen. I want to go very quickly to the word of the Lord. Amen. I would that you all would pray for me. Amen. Is any of my Carter Memorial family, are you out there? And my Carter Memorial family will pray for me. Amen. We'll be all right. I want to go very quickly to a very familiar passage of scripture. Two very familiar passages of scriptures. Amen. Found in the book of Exodus, the 33rd chapter and the 21st verse. And then in the division of Psalm 16 and 11. In Exodus 33, it says this. And the Lord says, behold, there is a place by me, and thou shalt stand upon a rock. And then in Psalms, the 16th division of Psalm and the 11th verse, it says, thou wilt show me the path of life. Amen. In thy presence, there is a fullness of joy. And there are pleasures there forevermore. And I want to use for a short theme, amen, for the next few fleeting moments, amen. Amen. Just look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, there is a place by me. Find another neighbor and say, neighbor, God said, there's a place by him. In our lives, we do our very best, amen, to find a level of placement, amen, to ensure and to reassure that everything that we do makes sense. It has to have a certain level or measure of alignment, amen, with what we do. We go to work and some of us have furthered our education, our endeavors to ensure that we have things, amen, in a certain place, and that everything lines up both naturally. And for those of us who name the name of God and believe in the faith of God, then there's also a spiritual placement that we must be in. Amen. I'm a firm believer that your blessing is always connected to a place. And so it is so imperative that as we do the things of God, amen, and we challenge ourselves, amen, to trust in the faith of God, amen, that we must stay in place, because if we are out of place, we can miss the hand of God or even miss the call of God on our lives. It is so important that we stay in place. And so the Bible says, amen, to Moses in this particular passage of scripture, where he was leading the children of Israel into the promised land and out of captivity, that when you go there, I want you to understand that you are not going there just for naught. You're not going there because you had nothing else to do, but you're going there because I have a place in mind for you. I have something beyond what you see right now and even beyond what you are experiencing in your life. And so in proximity between, amen, captivity and our promise, we go through certain trials and tribulations to knock us off course. And my pastor said something, amen, a few weeks ago, and I don't even really think some of the people really caught on to what he said in that prophetic moment. He said the last time was the last time. In other words, what the devil tries to do when he sends an attack to you, it is not so much to destroy you. He does not do that, because the truth of the matter is the devil does not care whether you live or die. The devil does not care, no disrespect, about your national position or your state position or your level of credit score. The devil doesn't care anything about red bottom or black bottom or how much money you make. No, what the job of the enemy, beloved, is to destroy your hope. And when the devil has destroyed your hope, he puts you in a place where he places you in something called mental, amen, captivity. He locks you up that you can't, amen, think straight. You can't praise God. You can't lift up your hands because you're so scattered in your mind because you are in a place of captivity. The devil comes to kill, steal, and to destroy. But beloveds, Mama Worship, if the devil takes our hope, we hope in the hope of glory. We praise by, amen, hoping that when we praise the Lord, when we clap our hands, when we shout, when we give and sow into the kingdom, it's an aspect of our faith. So if the devil destroys our hope, then we can shout all day long. But if you're dancing and shouting without no hope, you're doing it in vain. And so when God comes in, he comes in to restore your hope. And the Bible lets me know, amen, when David was under an unusual attack, beloved, David felt like his life was over. In fact, David told God, amen, it was nothing I did wrong. I had no right, amen, to do, amen, to be under this level of attack. When Saul was trying to destroy him, I had no right to be searching for berries and hiding myself, amen. I did nothing wrong. There were no injustices I've done. And sometimes, beloved, the devil, amen, is a master deceptor. He will make us believe that we've done something wrong when we're under attack. But I'm trying to let you know that what the devil is trying to do is to destroy your hope. For if you don't have hope, you don't have nothing. Look at your neighbor and say, whatever it is you lose, you may lose money, you may lose friends, you may lose prestige, whatever you do, if you have hope, you've got enough to start over again. I just need five people to just lift your hand and thank God for hope. You had some rough days, but you still got hope. I've had some broke days, but I still have hope. And David, while under this attack, he said, remember thy servant that has charged me to hope. In the midst of what David was going through in the division of Psalms, amen, 119 division, where's my car, your family? He said, I need you to know that it is you that has caused me to hope. Even though the enemy and my enemies are literally trying to destroy everything I've worked so hard for, but you have now charged me to hope, to believe that if I find myself in the presence of God, there then becomes a fullness of joy. And what that word fullness means, beloved, it means you become satisfied. I'm also from the South. I heard you, amen, Supervisor. And back home in the South, you all don't know nothing about that up here in Baltimore, but they used to do something called, amen, hot water cornbread. And you would mix the hot water cornbread and kind of mix it with your hands. I know it's not, you know, you just kind of get it together. But when you have some real good food, it does not matter how much it is. When you become full, you become satisfied. And sometimes we have the blessings of God. We have a prophetic encounter with God, but we still leave broken. That's because the devil has deceived you of your hope. But God says, if you find your way to the presence of God, I'm going to reestablish your hope. Because the Bible lets me know, as you get ready to go, Brother Dario, he said, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High God, he shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I'm trying to let you know that when the devil sends an attack to your family, when the devil sends an attack to your church, when the devil sends an attack to your ministry, he's not trying to deceive you. He's trying to rob you of your hope. But I need about four or five faith believers that know that you didn't come this far for the devil to take what you worked so hard for. I'm so close to my miracle. I can taste the anticipation. direction. Every time I wake up in the morning, I look up to the hills from which cometh my help, because I found out that my help comes from the Lord. And though they slay me, though they talk bad about me, though I don't fit in the in crowd, I still have hope enough to believe in God, that if God be for me, there's nobody in the world that can stand against me. That's why I love to lift up the name of the Lord, because the Bible says when you lift up his name, the name of the Lord is a strong tower, and then the righteous, they run in and they become